Snow White.
He's all excited about it.
Snow White Castle.
Huh?
Snow White Castle.
Whose castle?
Snow White.
Snow White's castle.
You should know.
Trey. Thank you. Where's Brittany at? Go up there by her, Brittany.
Ready to get out, Lincoln? Okay, go ahead, baby. Just stay at the clothes fire. Come look at the toy shop, Brittany. Bring him over here and look at the toy shop. Window.
Little people's town.
Hey guys, sit down on the step. Sit down on the step. Sit down on the step.
Wait.
Come on up here.
Wait, no, look at that. Sorry.
Try. Thank you.
That's not Mickey Mouse. That's the devil. Yeah, wait a minute. Don't jump out of there, okay? Look at those. Oh, that's Jiminy Cricket, baby.
La 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 la
the children, my children are reading tomorrow. If I get in the way, you can't come out.
How you doing? world on the move with all kinds of new forms of transportation. For instance, right now we're passing the Grand Prix Raceway, featuring them newfangled gas-powered vehicles. Well, they're newfangled vehicles. In front of us is the Red Way People Mover, a true transportation system of tomorrow. That's because it's powered by these things they call linear induction motors. If the name of those things don't sound futuristic, nothing does. To our left is one of the most exciting adventures in the Magic Kingdom.
There's the monorail. Trains running parallel to the track of the monorail.
And remember to gather all your personal belongings, including the youngest if you got it.
We'll get the bus.
Those of you staying with us, sit tight. We'll be on our way again in a few minutes. This is Main Street Station, Main Street, USA.
Rode a ferry like that one over here from the parking lot. House at Magic Kingdom. That's the bedroom where they sleep up on top of the tree.
Daddy, look!
What?
Daddy, look!
Look! My, my,
Daddy,
tree.
Look! You didn't look at me.
Water.
Water.
Get that.
Brittany, get in here, baby. Shit. Brittany, get over here. You better go through. There's a big crowd coming. Let's go.
Yeah.
Springs. Hello, say hi.
Hi.
Come on. Daddy.
stand, Carrie. Tell them to stand. We're at the Silver Springs. Today is, what is today? April the 16th, I think. It's Saturday, anyway.
Yeah, it's a camel.
Brittany, y'all look over here and wave. Brittany.
Can you feed them, Mommy?
No, baby, they were too big, okay? They get bigger food.
What food do they do?
Just big people, not big people,
camel,
but big.
Boy, he's wanting some.
Let me get a picture of him. Don't spit. I won't like that. What a profile. Handsome snout. Brittany,
just
a little bowl and
we'll
eat it
out.
Let's don't
eat it. We can feed that and me and mom. Mommy, I'm back. Mommy, this is my
dad's.
Hey,
drop it. Me. Come
on, Michael. Not you, Doug.
Not you, Doug.
Joe Rat.
I don't want to get on you. There's a mouth to fall. Yeah, it's stuck.
And Trey can't read the signs that say, do not climb on fence.
Wow, look at that. No, I just wanted to get it.
Check on.
Whoa, he's having it way up there in the clouds. No, yeah, this one's ours, baby. He's going back to that. He likes cats.
Hey, give him that food. He likes it very much.
The largest alligator ever found was in the state of Louisiana, and he was 19 feet 2 inches long. So we get excited about it. It happened about 100 years ago, and it is an unofficial record. Nowadays, it is very, very rare to find one over 12 feet in the wild. I know we were swimming one time, and a 6-foot alligator swam past you, and you swear to me it was 30 feet long.
Yeah.
They grow in situations like that, folks. It's amazing. Right now, in the state of Florida, there's over 1 million alligators, and they occupy just about every body of fresh water throughout the state. For many years, they were hunted by poachers because of the high values for their meats and for their hides. It got out of hand. They were nearly drove to extinction. Back in the early days, trust me, it does not go to a dead end. Does he have a glottis valve enabling the alligator to dismember his prey with water? It prevents water from going down his throat and drowning. It catches his prey up on the bank or above the water line, dragging into deeper water, start a spinning motion, tearing the prey to pieces, bring the pieces to the surface, open the epiglottis valve, and swallow those pieces down whole. About 200 years ago, the Seminole Indians discovered you could roll an alligator over on his back, rub his belly, and go to sleep. This is somewhat true. But actually, all you have to do to put an alligator to sleep, folks, is roll him over on his back. The part about rubbing the belly, it's called good showmanship. It's very scientific. The alligator's brain is encased in a cavity slightly larger than the brain, filled with liquid. Whenever you roll him over, the brain will push the liquid out of the cavity and rest on the top of his skull. Relax him out momentarily because the brain can no longer tell the rest of his body what to do. It doesn't hurt him. And I'd like to demonstrate it for you now. Often wondered how many Seminoles it took to figure this out. They were a lot bigger than this, trust me. We'll show them the shit for you. It'd be nice to get your kids to sleep that easy. I'll go ahead and wake him up, and he'll probably have that same gentle disposition that he had. Before I put him to sleep. Folks, I've been around alligators all my life. I mean, I've been around them. My parents have been raising them for about 35 years on a commercial alligator farm. I know what you're thinking. Why don't I work for Dad? Go work for your dad and find out how fun it is. I've learned a lot about this animal. There is one thing I'm going to clear up for you right now. There's a lot of people in this world. They're going to tell you that a 10-foot alligator can stand on all fours like a large lizard and outrun a full-grown man. I think you'd be very surprised how fast a man can run with a 10-foot alligator. I'll tell you something else. Earlier when that guy dropped that cigarette button, I had to jump in there and get it out. I'll tell you what, I don't care what Wesley Snipes said in that movie last year, but white men can jump, folks. I jumped about that high. Anyway, this is the American alligator. The next animal we're going to talk about. Quite possibly the most misunderstood. The most feared, despised, and the most hated animal on the face of this earth. No, not Barney.
No Barney.
Talk about a snake. What I brought for you folks today is a 9.5-foot Burmese python. Now, pythons are considered one of the 6 giant snakes in the world. Snakes are very closely related to your anacondas, to your boa constrictors. Now, there are some interesting features about snakes that I would like to share with you folks today. Something I've always been impressed with is his jaws. I want that picture. His jaws are hinged on what we call a musculature. It allows him to open his mouth and swallow prey up to 10 times his head size. His tongue goes in and out of his mouth periodically. Does anybody know what that's used for? Smell is exactly right. What he does, he sticks his tongue out, grabs particles from the surrounding air, brings them back to a special organ in the roof of his mouth called the Jacobson's organ. It deciphers and it lets the snake know what's around. We When you talk about snakes, you're always going to hear misconceptions. A lot of people think that they're wet and slimy. Snakes are very dry. They feel like dry cool. Anybody here, by a show of hands, ever heard of a snake? We're doing real good now. The coach whip looks very much like a braided whip. He will not chase you down and bite you and whip you to death with his tail. They don't have a sting on their tail. They whip you to death with, and the tongue doesn't come out stinging. The water moccasin. Very aggressive snake. Out of all the snakes I've ever handled in my life, it makes me very nervous. I respect the moccasin very highly. It's a very thick-bodied snake, therefore he's very strong. I don't know if you notice or not, but you can grab a moccasin behind his head. He'll bite right down through his bottom jaw and take that venom into you like that. It's an act of defense. They've got the nastiest disposition I've ever seen in my life, other than my mom on Saturday morning. They will not swing you down and bite you, but they will drop in your boat from time to time. Has this ever happened to anybody? Now, I tell you, there's not a show goes by that it hasn't happened to somebody. It's very common. It happened to me one time, back when I was 15 years old. That wasn't very long ago. I wanted a canoe because I like to do a lot, I like to fish. To let y'all in on a little something, I'm the world's greatest fisher. They call me the Bass and Assassin. I wanted a canoe, and my dad's the type that never gave me anything unless I earned something like that. He wanted me to be more, I guess it made me more proud of it. And it did. One time I asked him for allowance, you know what he told me? I'll never forget it. He said, "Johnny, did you eat this morning?" I said, "Yes, sir." He said, "There you go, buddy. Go to work." He bought me the canoe. He worked my tail off for it. He should have bought me a yacht. I got a canoe.
Brittany.
Come here, Nicole. Come over here. Guys, come here. Not in the flowers. Over here. Brittany.
This is still at Silver Springs. We're going back over to pet the animals. Fixing to leave, and they're wanting to pet the animals again. So this is the walkway back over to the petting zoo. River's right out behind all of that. See the boat. Trey is chasing a squirrel up a tree.
Thank you.
opposite twins. Little squirrel Brittany was trying to chase. Get up there.
Tell Uncle Michael and Susie.
Turn around, Trey, and wave at me.
Tell Uncle Trey, Rosie's calling her to everybody, huh? Oh, boy, come on.
Everybody. You need a quarter, huh?
Yeah, thank you.
How y'all doing? Boy in the dirt. Yeah, that's it. Wipe it on yourself. There's the flower girls. And have a baby. What a beauty.
Hi, do you want to bait it? Come here, I'll give you some.
Brittany, don't run after it like that. Don't run, Trey. You'll scare him, baby. Here, Trey.
Want to bait him?
Save some for the deer, bud. Mary.
Huh?
Save some for the deer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
No, the
or was, oh, the gate was locked. Okay.
Let's go. We can feed the things.
Camel?
Giraffe. Come on, let's go feed the giraffe.
Oh, okay. Giraffe.
Where you at? Come on, let's go feed the giraffe.
Y'all go feed the giraffe?
Come on,
baby.
Bye-bye.
Come on,
guys.
Come
on,
go.
Yeah.
Don't.
Yeah.
Get the
Keep going, Britt. Brittany, run out there in the water. Go play in the edge of the water. Starting to rain. Feels like.
What?
Feels like it might start to rain.
Dennis himself. There he goes again.
You say that. Do you hear me? You need to do something. You say, okay? You hear me? Make sure you say. You need to be. I'm going to read some of the news that I know I can make it up. And tell Daddy to look.
All right. There's our castle. I told you to use the sand stuff for me. Use it. Brittany, get your hands out of it. Come here, both of you. Excuse me. Come here, Brittany.
Brittany, you're gonna knock your castle over!
I don't want you to put your hand back in the dirt. Open up, okay? I'm gonna find a place for you. Okay, make sure I try. Hi.
Okay.
No. Come here. Okay, now after we do that.
Trey, wave at me.
Okay, tomorrow when it's sunny, get up here now. Okay, when it's sunny tomorrow, come back, okay? Hear me? Hold it. Hold on. Here, Brittany, here. Hold this one. Brittany, stop doing this thing. I can actually do this. Stop. No. You're not going back out. Let's go.
Wave bye to the castle.
Bye.
Yeah, we'll make another one. We'll make a big one.
Big one.
See the sun's on there. Come on, let's go.
That's a replica of the spaceship.
Come here and take a picture.
cuisine, c'est ça en fait.
Hein? C'est le question de la cuisine.
Oui, oui.
Mais c'est le goût. Pas le goût de haut, hein, le goût qui est accroché à la cuisine.
Ah, d'accord.
Measuring and recording, bit by bit, the mysteries of this vast, secret ocean upon which we Earthlings and our planet must navigate. Towards tiny points of light, millions of miles beyond the tips of our fingers, we've cast...
The first launch pad was used to send a spacecraft up in space in 1958. Small compared to the ones now. Different types of rockets and different things that they've tested and experimented with.
Daddy, let's go.
Some of the many different experiments that they've done. Shepard, the first man
to go into orbit.
Go into space was launched from right there.
John Glenn. First one to orbit.
There's the
yeah, it
little
like
bitty building that they
are working on it.
Tracked him from.
The blockhouse that they used back then to launch Alan Shepard and up here into a 42-foot flame trench. So as they say, we've come a long way. And they're fixing this all up too. I see they're planting trees out through here and everything. This is going to be very nice. It was nice before, but it'll be shady. It'll keep some of that sun off as we come over through here.
Hmm.
And here's our land safe vehicle over here. Everybody get a chance to walk out all through all these?
Yeah.
You got a map there that tells you?
From underground silos, 12 feet in diameter and 100 feet deep. The concrete blockhouses resembling large beehives were the control centers during countdown and launch. The silos are now the storage site for the Space Shuttle Challenger debris.
House was built in 1898.
Did I get in front of the door? Okay. I leaned down just but I heard you say, but I thought, oh, I hope not.
The lighthouse ahead was built in 1898.
Sundial that has the names of the astronauts that have gotten killed, died, whatever.
Yeah.
right deep.
Uh-uh, no, sir. No, sir. Don't be stealing sunglasses. I need to get you some.
Challenger when it exploded. School teacher.